Hello and welcome to this Rhapsody Tip of the Day video. This video explains how UML one-to-many relationships are implemented in Rhapsody in the context of code generation. In order to communicate or send messages or to exchange data, objects need to know each other. UML provides different kinds of relationships, like association, aggregation or composition, to show how things are grouped together or relate to each other. The simplest relationship is the association, as shown in the diagram. The multiplicity of 1 at the end of this directed association indicates that a mind factory object will have a connection to an idea object during execution. For this case, Rhapsody generates a pointer for the role name of the relationship. This pointer will hold the address of the related object, that is, address pointer, to the idea object during runtime. The one-to-one relationship is quite simple, one single pointer for one related object. But what if I have a one-to-many relationship, which is indicated by an asterisk? That is, when one object is related to many other. How is this case implemented in Rhapsody? In the source code we see that Rhapsody uses the concept of a collection, which is in this case is a type-safe, dynamically sized array with OM collection as an unordered, unbounded container. So this concept is like a bag, where I can put and place elements without any specific order or information of a position. When I activate the corresponding property to ordered, Rhapsody uses a linked list instead. In this case we have a list of elements, where each element points to the next. The container class OMList contains a number of different operations for adding and removing items from the list, and Rhapsody generates helper functions to use these. These container concepts are part of the Object Execution Framework, OXF, indicated by the prefix OM, which you can use to build your application. And there are more of them, beside the typical containers like lists, collections, we have also maps, stacks, heaps, static arrays. Each with its own set of behaviors. Instead of its native container library, you can configure Rhapsody to use an off-the-shelf container library, for example, RogueWave, MFC, or the standard template library, STL, or any other. By using the property cpp_cg, configuration, container set, we can switch to STL containers, for example, which is supported out of the box by Rhapsody. For this video, we will stay with the Rhapsody native container. So let's move to action. In this model, I have a mind factor class, which can hold relationships to many ideas. The mode of operation is as follows. When the mind factory object receives command create idea, it will react on it by calling its create idea operation, which will create a new idea object and increment the idea counter. The idea counter thus holds the information about the amount of created ideas. When the mind factory receives the command notify ideas, it will call its notify ideas operation, which will go through the list of ideas and call the notify operation. This reactive behavior is implemented via the following state chart. At the beginning, we initialize the idea counter to 0. When we receive CMD create idea, the create idea operation is called. In the implementation of this operation, the idea counter is increment. Then a new idea object is created by passing the idea counter as argument to the constructor. The pointer to the new object is then added to the linked list. On the other side, in the initializer of the idea constructor, we assign the value of the idea counter to the member attribute m_id. In the constructor itself, we print the message that the object was successfully created. So let's us look at the case when we receive CMD notify ideas. In this case, the operation notify ideas is called, in which we iterate through the list of ideas, to call their respective notify operation. The ideas notify operation simply prints a notify message with its identifier. So now, let's bring this to life. I am running the application in animation mode so that we can see the animated sequence diagram and state chart. Initially, we have one Mind Factory object. The corresponding list of connected ideas is currently empty, and the counter is zero. When I send the message CMDCreateIdea to the Mind Factory, we see, in the sequence diagram, that the operation CreateIdea is called, which creates a new idea lifeline. Now, let us leave our inspiration flow and create some more ideas. In the features dialog of the Mind Factory, we see the new created and connected ideas. Sending the CMD notify ideas message causes the Mind Factory to notify its ideas. That's it. I hope you are now as inspired as I am. The model is available on www.rhapsody.guru. So have fun with creating your own ideas. Don't forget to like and share it. Wishing you an inspiring day.